What's up, everyone? How are you doing? In this video, we're going to discuss rimless tanks versus rim tanks. And I kind of went down this rabbit hole because I was just looking into the rimless tanks because I love the way they look. They got a nice, sleek appearance, give you a more modern look. And if you're going to do a show tank, you got to go rimless. You'll never go to an aquascape contest and see a bunch of rim tanks in there, right? So I've definitely looked into them. And it brought up a few questions though, because I am cheap, so I thought of a couple other ideas, you know, like why can't I just do a dollar per gallon sale and just take that rim off that tank? After reading around on the webs, on the internet, I came up with a few issues. So apparently the glass on a rimless tank versus those tanks is a lot thicker. So if you were to go to one of these dollar per gallon sales and get those rim tanks and just pull off that piece of plastic, which apparently does a lot more support than I thought it did, it's actually going to start to bow and then could shatter the glass. So that's definitely a no-no. So other things that might influence your decision to figure out whether a rimmed or a rimless tank is worth it. On the rimless side, I really like to not have a top on it, and just to have a clean look between the water itself and transitioning to the top. So that really gives it a nice look. But if you're gonna be someone that keeps fish that jump or snails, you may have end up with a lot of dead livestock. So that might not be the best idea for you. And it might be just worth it just to go ahead and get the rim tank and put the regular top on there anyway. Another benefit that I was reading is that some people actually enjoy the rim tank because it covers up the water line. Like, they like to fill it up past the rim itself so you can't see that water line and it just looks like it's under the water. Where others actually prefer the rimless tank because they say it gives it more aquatic experience because you can actually see the water line rippling at the top. Whatever you are, you know, you can make your own decision, but yeah, I thought that was kind of odd one. So after it was all said and done, I ended up getting the wheels turning up here, and it gave me some ideas, you know, like what about Euro bracing on one of those thinner glass tanks? Would that be enough to support that thin glass and still give me the rimless tank look that I want? Another option, you know, if it's shorter, like if I were to build my own out of glass and I didn't put too much pressure on it, you know, what size glass would I need and how cost effective is that versus just buying one outright? So this is essentially just made me wonder a lot of things, and yeah, you're probably gonna see some projects in the future in this channel where I start building my own tanks and such to see how it goes. Maybe we even do some stress testing on some of this glass. I don't know. We'll have to find out what the safest way is of doing that. So I hope this answers some of the common questions that you have when I started researching this on the internet, as well as that maybe it gave you a little bit of those creative juices flowing, you know. Maybe you might start doing your own tanks and see what you could do with it. And if you've ever tried any of these things, make sure to comment below and let me know. But until next time, guys,